and karma. See, this is this is Sanskrit word. This is Sanskrit word Panchakarma, and this is totally a detoxification therapy is mentioned. That is in five types of purificatory of purificatory procedure. Five type of purificatory procedure. Now, what is purification? What is purification?
Detoxification.
That is another word in modern way. You can say detoxification. Yeah. Cleansing the mind, cleansing the body, entire body. That is called purificatory procedure. And this purificatory procedure has greater importance in Ayurveda. Because in Rigveda, you will find some passages in Rigveda textbook. Because Ayurveda is a part of Atharvaveda. So they have mentioned about this in those days in Vedic period. People were used to for these different types of purificatory therapies. Now, what are the purificatory procedures and what are the therapies? First is oleation. Second is fermentation. This is the this is called Purva Karma. Application of oil, that is called oleation. Yeah. Application of oil. Application of oil from head to toe, entire body. And this is fermentation. After that, you can do some steams and everything. 10-15 minutes. Fermentation is only for 15 minutes. This is for 30 to 40 minutes application of oil. But before starting this main procedure, you have to do this thing first. Otherwise, you won't get, proper result. I mean, all the dosas, biological humors, that is called Vata, Pitta and Kapha, this is called biological humors. Or bodily humors. So these are all the three bodily humors are responsible for creating disease or producing disease. Bodily humors or biological humors. This is called dosas, vata, pitta, humors, H-U-M-O-R-S, humors. So vata, pitta, that is called dosha. In our language we can say dosha, vata, pitta and kapha. So these are the responsible. Yeah, all these are responsible for producing the disease. So for that disease, we have to purify through this Panchakarma. So now what are the Panchakarma? This is the preparatory measures, preparatory therapy. Suppose if you...
Water is hava.
Yeah, air. Air, fire and water substance. Water substance. This body is formation of Panch Mahabhutas. Five types of are there. So this is air, this is fire. Now I will give you some basic idea of Vata, Pitta and Kapha, and then I will switch over to Panchakarma. This is for movements, you can say. in common men's language, vata is called movements. All type of movements is related to vata. This is pitta is metabolism. Metabolism and digestion, that is pitta dosha. Metabolism and digestion. And this is cough is a structure of body. This is kapha or nourishment. So vata, pitta and kapha, these three biological humors, three dosas are there, and three prakrutis are there in each and every human being: vata, pitta and kapha. So different people have different type of prakruti. Some have vata pitta, some have pitta kapha, or some have vata pitta and kapha. It depends on genetics. Yeah, that is vata nadi pitta. Yeah, it's that is totally different subject. It's a pulse reading, pulse diagnosis. Yeah, see, we have to check here our radial pulse rate, this radial. Yeah, from that we can say that whether it is vata, pitta or kapha. So this is preparatory measure, oleation and fomentation is preparatory measures. Before starting main therapy, we have to do always this thing, oleation and fomentation, applying the oil on the entire body and then fomentation. And now Panchakarma is five types of purification, detoxification therapy. Number one is emesis. Right? That is called woman. Emesis, this is purgation, that is virechan. Purgation, purgation, P-U-R-G-A-T-I-O-N, purgation, virechan. This is anima, that is called vasti. Number four is nasya, I mean nasal drops, or snuff, that is called nasya. And last is bloodletting, that is rakta mokshan. Yeah, rakta mokshan. This is called five types of purificatory procedure. In modern element you can say detoxification therapy, both are the same, purificatory and detoxification therapy. So
after this, going for this.
Yeah, Panchakarma. Before that, you have to do this procedure.
And then this also they do in that setting only.
Yeah, it depends on different type of disease, which disease person is having. So according to, we decide which therapy is suitable to particular disease.
Applicable to all.
Yes, but first you have to do this. This is applicable to all. And then out of five, we decide which procedure is required for particular disease. Like person is having a rhinitis or sinusitis or some headache problem, then we suggest this thing, nasal drops. Because all the problem above the collarbones, you see, is headache and sneezing and nasal discharge and pain in the head, everything, toothache, everything, it comes under this nasal therapy. So nasal drops or medicated oil we are giving through this nasal route. So that is applicable. All this trigeminal neuralgia problem.
Is there any age group for Panchakarma or anybody can do?
Up to 80 years. 8 to 80 years. Before 8 we can do this massage, because in kids we are doing massage and all this therapy, that is applicable. But these procedures are not allowed in kids. So 8 to 80, that is the limit. Right? Now the role of Panchakarma is curative and preventive both. Curative and preventive, or prevention of disease. Disease is from the root. This is the main purpose of this therapy, curative and prevention of the disease from the root. Otherwise, simply if you take any Ayurvedic medicine, it doesn't work. But if you go through proper system or proper this therapy, like this fomentation and massage, if you do regularly, you can live 100 years without any type of disease and any type of problems, mental or physical. See, in southern India, in every household, people are doing this oleation, massage, either through that til tail or that coconut oil.
Any oil.
Yeah, but usually til tail is the most preferable, til tail, right? So you can do this application of oil at your residence, at your premises, fomentation, that hot water, that you can do. Now, there are three stages of Panchakarma, three stages. Number one is Purva Karma. Purva Karma, that is preparatory measure. This is Pradhan Karma. Main therapy or treatment. And Paschat Karma. These all are Sanskrit words, Purva Karma, Pradhan Karma, Pascha, because it is Vedic science. It's a 5,000 year old written, and this is proven science. In Vedic period, all the physicians in Mesopotamian civilizations, they were doing all these procedures. They were using a different type of, I will come to that point, Paschat Karma. That is called aftercare. Or rehabilitative measure. Rehabilitative measures. I will give you one example. When you go for surgery on operation table, first, that surgeon will do, once you enter in the operation theater, what is the preparatory measure? Anesthetist, they will come and give you anesthesia. Second main therapy is operation. And after that, post-operative. What is post-operative? Medicines, diet, etc. Here, same. Aftercare or rehabilitative measures. This is preparatory measure. Application of oil. And then fermentation. Right, this is preparatory application of oil and then fermentation. This is main. Now pradhan karma, you know all the pradhan karmas. Now MSCs. Here you can say drug-induced MSCs. Drug-induced MSCs. Because we are using all the drugs. And then vomiting, you can produce these MSCs. Without drugs, you can't do. Yeah.
Woman.
Yeah, MSCs. That is called woman.
Vomiting.
That is called woman. Yeah. Vomiting or woman. This is Sanskrit word. This is English word, right? Vomiting and woman. So usually we use rock salt and honey. This is additive or vehicle, additive or vehicle, rock salt and honey to produce woman. Vehicle. Now vehicle of drugs. This is additives. We have to add this thing. Whatever medicine we prepare for woman, we have to add this. So that is called additive or vehicle. So now, a licorice, sugarcane juice, usually we prefer this herb, licorice and sugarcane juice. If you take sugarcane juice up to here, full stomach, and you add some rock salt, then automatically you will produce vomiting. So there are so many other herbs are there, but this is the main, licorice and sugarcane juice. We can give this, and it is applicable in indications of woman. Indication of woman, in which disease this woman we can do, which disease particularly.
Can we do it in water?
Which?
Water and rock salt.
Warm water and rock salt it can produce. Warm water and sugarcane juice, this licorice juice or licorice decoction, that can produce also. Now indication of woman. This is of main cough related problem. Cough related diseases. Woman is applicable in cough related disease. All type of cough related, this tuberculosis and bronchitis, asthma, pharyngitis, all type of cough related disease. This is the indication for woman. Why? Because it cleanses the chest and stomach. This woman is, it cleanses the chest and stomach. So it clears all type of TB, bronchitis, asthma, pharyngitis and other type of disease. Usually we are applying. Second is purgation. I think each and everybody has taken some purgative or laxative drugs for various type of disease, particularly constipation problem, because 80-90% population suffering from constipation and gas. So purgation, there are three types of purgation. One is laxative, second is mild purgative and strong purgative. Three types of purgatives are there. And all types of dosas or pitta related disease. Pitta related disease comes out through anal region all types of pitta related disease, because this purgation, that is called virechan. Virechan is applicable in pitta related disease. There are so many herbs. Raisins, sena, isabgul and figs. These all are purgatives. These are all substance, raisins, senas, that munakka black, right? Sena, isabgul, figs, these all are purgatives or mild, purgative or sena. Sena is seed. No. Yes. Sona Mukhi is type. Sena. Purgation, okay, laxative, mild purgative, strong purgatives. This piles, fistula, fissures, GI disorders. This is applicable in all type of anorectal disease. Gastrointestinal disorders, that is called GI disorders. So, anorectal disease, you can give all this isabgol, and even you can give this haritaki powder and trifla also. These all are mild laxative, not purgative or strong purgative. Haritaki, that is harde powder, trifla powder is commonly available. this henna isabul pack is there. You can take 1 teaspoon, 2 teaspoon.
Trifla
at all Ayurvedic shop. Ayurvedic shop.
But is it
pure? Pure, pure, pure. Yes, yes. It is pure.
And dosage? What is the dosage?
5 grams. It depends on your that.
And it has to be taken
With warm water, lukewarm water. Yeah.
5 grams.
1 teaspoon. 1 teaspoon. Maximum 2 teaspoon. If you are, if you take one day 5 gram, your bowels are not clear, then you take 2 teaspoon. It is not harmful.
And can it be taken every day?
Every day. It's rejuvenation. It gives rejuvenation, rasayan effect to your body. There is no any harm. Regularly you can take this. So all the anorectal diseases. Virechan purgation is applicable in all the anorectal diseases. Right? Now third is enema. That is called vasti. There are two types of enema. One is oil based and decoction based. Simply oil, and this is mixing with herbs or decoction. This is plain oil, til tail, or castor oil. See, enema, this is a for vata. So all the movement and all the gastrointestinal problems, that is related to vata. So for that purpose, we are giving this enema, vasti, through anal root, oil based, til tail or castor oil. You can take this regularly or every alternate day. ml to 100 ml through anal root, and this is decoction based.
Enema is through anal
root. Through anal root. No, not by oral root, anal root. So oil based and decoction based. This enema. Now this is applicable to all neurological problems. What is neurological problems? Paralysis, Parkinson's, others is osteoarthritis. So all the stiffness in the body, rheumatism, for this decoction base, yeah. Mixing herbs in that, and we are preparing that enema.
In oil?
Yeah, in decoction. This is totally decoction, no oil. Oil is different. Here we are using til tail, castor oil, or medicated oil. We are mixing some herbs, and it's all the medicated. This is purely decoction. There is no medicated oil.
Achha, herbs you mix it?
Yeah. So this is available in kashai, all the Dashmula and Maharasnadi, that is called decoction. So, yeah, packet or in bottle form, it is prepared form is there, yeah. Liquid form is available, but usually we are preparing and then we are giving. That is 700 ml to 1.25 later. For various type of neurological problems, paralysis, Parkinson, osteoarthritis, stiffness, rheumatisms, and general weakness, right? So this is enema, two types of enema, and third one is called Uttarvasthi. What is Uttarvasthi? One, two, and three. This is particularly given in through this urethra. Uttarvasthi is given by this root in male and through vaginal root in women. Now this urethra, this is for particularly genitourinary disorders in male, and in women some menstruation related problems. Uttarvasthi, this is the root of Uttarvasthi in male through urethra, and this is in women. Okay. See, this all erectile dysfunction in male. This is leucorrhea, menorrhagia, PCOD, ovarian cyst, fibroid. So usually we are giving in this disease in women, all this through this vaginal route. But before that, we are doing this preparatory measure, this application of oil and fomentation, that is required. Otherwise, it won't give result.
So,
which cancer? Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. CA of ovary. Yes, you can give leucorrhea, menorrhagia, PCOD, irregular periods. Infertility. This is here's male impotency. There are so many diseases in genitourinary, and particularly in women, leucorrhea, menorrhagia, PCOD, ovarian cyst, all type of chronic diseases. So enema, oil-based, decoction, and Uttarvasthi. Yes? Medicines is different oils and herbal preparations are there. So if I say this leucorrhea problem is there in ladies, then what we are doing? decoction of five barks, five tree, decoction of five tree barks like neem and peepal, and you see, so there are five types of trees barks, and for that we are preparing decoction of this five barks, and we are giving in this leucorrhea patients. You can say this vaginal douche also. Uttar was the vaginal douche through this vagina root. Correct? Third, fourth, nasya. That is called nasal drops. Or powder. Or medicated oil. Or ghee. Nasya. Nasal drops, powder, snuff. Lot of women in villages, they are taking snuff. That is called the same, this nasya. Now, usually, if you want to do on regular basis nasya, you can do at home nasya. This anu tailam and shadbindu. Two drops daily in each nostril. This is very simple procedure, you can do at home. There is no any harm. Regular practice, I mean. Anu Tailam and Sadabindu Tailam. This is available in the market, freely available. The bottle 50 ml, 100 ml, it's very cheap. And with the help of dropper, you can just tilt your neck and add two drops every day, I mean before breakfast and in the evening, two times you can do this. If you do this regularly, see, now there are indications for nasya, because above the collarbones, all type of disease of hair, falling of hair, falling of hair, premature graying of hair, sinusitis, migraine, trigeminal neuralgia, allergic rhinitis, so this is the indication for nasya therapy, nasya treatment. Trigeminal neuralgia, NURALGIA. See, trigeminal, this is a very killer disease. Trigeminal. Salman Khan is having the same problem. He has suffered since last 7 years, still is suffering. Trigeminal neuralgia, unilateral, you can feel electric shock like pain. You can't do your regular activities like brushing your teeth, or you can't eat your food, or you can't laugh, you can't speak loudly. When you do all these things, you will feel severe pain. So it's totally unilateral. It starts from here and radiates down here, it comes up to here, all the maxilla and mandible. It's a severe pain, it's uncontrollable. So in that, this nasya therapy is good. Yes, nasya therapy. There are other oil is maha masha tailam. Masha MSH masha tailam. Maha masha tailam. This is also available. You can but under Ayurvedic physician supervision, because this badam tail for yeah, you can add, but this is best. Shadbindu Anu tail. It improves your memory, intellect powers and everything. This is Nasya. Last is bloodletting, Rakta Moksha. Now there are two ways to remove the blood from the body. One is through a metallic instrument. Second is leech application. To remove the blood. So this is non-poisonous leech, not poisonous leech. And this Rakta Moksha is indicated in all the skin disorders, obstinated skin disorders particularly, not skin but obstinated. Obstinated, what is obstinated skin disorders? Eczema, this psoriasis, and you see, this type of disease is totally obstinated. You can't, cure with the help of this medicine. I'll tell you, we are applying on the particular part. If a person is having eczema, then what we are doing, we are applying the leech on that part. But before that, this turmeric plus mustard powder we are applying to remove the impurities from that leeches. After that, when leech sucks the blood, impure blood, then again we apply this thing. So leech vomits the impure blood, again apply. So 2, 3, 4, not a single leech application is not, enough, but at least 2 to 3 at a time we can apply and remove all types of impurities in the blood. Yeah, that is, yeah, they will suck. Like, see, this, no, leucoderma, it's not applicable. In white, this swan, what he is doing, so mixtures of milk and water. Now what swan will do? He will suck the milk. He won't suck that water. So same way here, impure blood will suck by leech. Pure blood he won't suck. Wherever is impure blood is in the body. And second is through this syringe. Metallic syringe, through that way, you have to remove that blood. In hypertensive patient, you can remove that blood and stabilize the pressures. So there are two ways. One is, but usually this leech application is more preferable. In Western world, this therapy is now, all the concept, they have accepted leech application. Yeah, it is here we are doing leech application, but we have to store in that glass jar and we have to buy from the market, otherwise it's very difficult. some in Mahim or some that area or Matunga.
Fish stores
there? I think they must have this leech. But not poisonous leech, non-poisonous leech. Otherwise, it will create... Yeah, they knows, I mean, all this, those people who are selling this, no? They knows the quality of the leeches. Right, Raktamokshan.
Can medical screening be done?
Yes. Yeah.
In that, what procedure you follow after an oil and?
Fermentation. Yes. Then leech applications.
Huh?
Then leech application. You can apply this. Leech.
In varicose vein.
Yeah, yeah, you can do leech application. Yeah, that is also the skin problem. Varicosity of this, you see, veins. That is also applicable. Now last is, this is fifth. Now Panchakarma. What is Panchakarma? Aftercare. Or Panchakarma, that is aftercare. After doing this, all the therapies, Panchakarma procedures. Number one is dietary measures, drugs, and number three, daily routine. This is required, but before that you have to clean the entire system. See, this is totally cleansing therapy. Detoxification, purification, and then we start this therapy. Dietary measures, what the diet particular person or particular type of constitutions, body's constitution, accordingly we prescribe the diet, and then drugs. If you take drugs after this cleansing therapy, it works wonders. I mean, you can't imagine the results. I mean, excellent. But otherwise, you take for longer duration all the medicines. And see, Ayurvedic medicine has a role, but after purification, result is very, I mean, fantastic. Drugs and daily routine, that is dos and dons. This is very important, daily routine, dos and dons. Yeah, restriction is there. See, dietary measures, I tell you, all of a sudden we are not starting this solid diet like gruel. We start from this gruel, this soup. See, all the liquids. Gruel, that kanji, soup, liquids. This is the diet usually we prescribe after Panchakarma, and according to one's digestive capacity. Because if you start this solid food, then the problem will be aggravated. So start from this liquid, then semi-solid, and then solid last. Usually it takes 7 to 10 days. Or restoration of digestion power. after Panchakarma therapy, take 7 to 10 days to restore your digestion power. Because different person have different type of digestion power. So accordingly, but main is this. Then semi-solid and then solid. Semi-solid like this, khichdis and all these things. Rice and this type of semi-solid and then solid. Your vegetables, all these things. Fruits, everything. Correct? And then medicine. For particular type of disease like trigeminal neuralgias and allergic rhinitis. So, see, allergic rhinitis patient feels always heaviness in the head. Rhinitis. Heaviness in the head, nasal discharge and everything. So we recommend a certain type of diets and then drugs. All type of problems, daily routines, what to do, avoid all the exposure of to wind and ACs and everything. AC, then cold water, fan. So we have to avoid all these things last. So these are the aftercare rehabilitation. Usually this is in this time, I mean in current period, 52 days is the minimum days required for Panchakarma. 52 days regularly. Don't skip a daily, not to skip a single day. 52 days constantly you have to follow this, all the procedures. For entire Panchakarma procedure takes 45 to 52 days, and maximum is I think 120 days maximum Panchakarma. But it's very costly treatment. This treatment is very costly.
How much does one sitting cost? It
depends on the centers. We are charging, because I am attached with Birla Kerala Vaidyashala. So at least 2000 rupees for 45 minutes treatment. But it depends on which therapy you prefer. Suppose if you prefer Nasya therapy, then I think 350 rupees. This is only 15 minutes procedure.
Full body massage.
Full body massage, is, yes. This is a...
So means this one sitting means full body massage?
No.
With that...
That is different.
Swimming or whatever?
Yeah, that I'll give you.
That will be done first, na?
Yeah, first and then this. But we are doing just local, all the application. We have some packages. That is called 60 minutes Abhyangam, 1800 rupees, sorry, here. 60 minutes. That is called Abhyangam, entire body oil application. 60 minutes is 1800 rupees. Some Nasya is 15 minutes, 300 rupees. And
that 60 minutes is only oil massage.
Oil massage, two hands oil massage, two hands.
Not entire body.
Two hands. Two hands. Entire body means four hands. Four hands. Two therapists, four hands. This is entire body. Na? So that is 1800 rupees for 60 minutes.
So two people will do?
Yeah, two people will do.
Why, one can't do?
No, one can't do. So both sides, na? Right and left. Both sides. And front side and back side. From head to toe. So minimum 60 minutes is required. And then after then that fermentation or that sweat.
And then one of those treatment.
Yeah, 15 minutes for fermentation and then the main procedure that Panchakarma Nasya or Vaman or purgation, whatever is required. Yeah, but there is some package. Suppose if you take for 10 days this, then the cost would be reduced. So we are giving in package, that is therapeutic package, that is called therapeutic package. Even we are giving some beauty treatment. Beauty treatment for ladies. So there are so many types of therapies available at our center. Beauty treatment, bridal packages, panchkarmas and Sirodhara, Sirovasti, that is the part of the Panchakarma. Sirodhara, Sirovasti, foot, Abhyangam, massage.
Sirodhara and all comes in that one massage?
Yeah, no, that comes under therapeutic package. And that package will cost you for 10 days, 20,000 rupees. 10 days is 20,000. So all this massage and fermentation. Sirodhara, Vasti, everything for 10 days.
Vasti,
that is anima.
How many hours?
2.5. Yeah, maximum 2.5. Minimum 1.5. That is required because massage, entire body massage requires at least 45 minutes. Yeah, and then 15 minutes that steam and all the. So 1 hour goes in that. Preparatory measures and then main treatment comes. So this is the Panchakarma detoxification therapy. After cleansing the entire body, you can reap the benefits of this Panchakarma. Otherwise, there is no any role.
What drugs are you not explaining?
For rheumatic pain? So there are so many oils are there. Mahanarayan tail is there for rheumatic arthritis.
How much does the leech therapy cost?
Leech therapy. I think it is not here, but if anybody is interested in leech therapy, then I can give you some estimate. Yeah, everywhere in Western countries, I mean mostly all the countries. Okay, any questions now? What?